Hello friends, welcome to BSC Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about entomology's crop wise pest classification. I am going to cover the topic pest of castor. So as usual, I have already given the number of pests which was present in castor and their common names as well as their scientific name, and the third one is their family and the fourth one is their order. So let's move to the video directly. So the first one I am going to tell you about is capsule borer, where the scientific name is Conogetes punctiferalis. So the symptom is the capsule which used to bore through the holes, and it also causes the webbing damage by placing the both capsules together, and also they used to make a galleries made of silk and frass in the webbed capsules. It is the major symptom of a capsule borer. And so while seeing about their identification, the larva, which is said to be a pale greenish with pinkish tinge, as also they used to have a fine hairs with a dark head as well as prothoracic sheath, and the adult, which is said to be yellowish with black spot, is the characteristics nature of the capsule borer we must need for identification. And so while for the management practices, we can able to remove the infested shoot and capsules, so which can be collected and destroyed in the early stages. And the next one is the chemical management method, where we can able to spray profenopause at 1.5 ml per liter, or else the monocrotopause or quinal pause at 2 ml per liter of water in the field level is the effective management against capsule borers. And these are the identification one I have already told you. But the pupation, which is said to be taken place in a silkened cocoon, which used to be happen in stem or else inside the capsules, and in egg, which is said to be laid on tender parts of the leaves. So it is the classification of capsule borer. And the next one we are going to see is castor semilupar, where the castor semilupar used to be of two types. The first one is Achaea genata, and the second one is Disconia algira. And the other name of Disconia algira is Parallelia algira. So they they both used to cause the same symptom of damage to the castor crop, where they causes defoliation, which used to mix the plant only with leaf bearer stems as well as veins. So while for the identification purpose in Achaea genata, where the larva, which is a semilupar, which used to have varying shades of color with a black head as well as abdomen, which used to have a red spot on the third abdominal segment and red tubercles on the anal region, and the adult, which is said to be pale reddish brown moth as well as with the hind wings, which used to have a white band in the middle as well as three large white spots on the outer margin, is the characteristics of Achaea genata. While saying about Disconia algira, the larva, which is a semilupar with olive green color with numerous longitudinal lines, is the characteristic nature of Disconia algira. And the adult in four wings, it used to have white color soft band beyond it, and in hind wings, it used to have a outer margin gray at the center with a white high white median band present in them, is the characteristics of hind wing in Disconia algira. So it is a picture of Achaea genata as well as Parallelia algira. And it was some other identification purpose we can able to see in castor semilupar. So but I have already mentioned the major important things in those slides, so please see that see these and the material for your study purpose. And the management practices is mainly hand picking of odor larva during early stages, and also provide bird purchase at the rate of 10 per acre, which reduces the incidence, or else we can able to go for the spraying of extracts like neem seed kernel extract at 5% in the early stages. And also we can also release parasitoids like Trichogramma species at 50,000 per acre, or else the final one we can able to move for the chemical sprayings like spray carbaryl at 3 gram, or quinal pause or chloripyrifos or monocrotopos at 2 ml per liter of water. If the 4 or 5 semilupar per plant are observed in 30 or 40 days of old seedlings, it is an effective one to control the semilupars. So it was the picture of castor semilupar Achaea genata and castor. And next we can able to go for castor slug caterpillar, where the scientific name is Parasa lepida, and the family Cochlidae. So while seeing about the egg, which is said to be flat and shining in nature, and they are said to be laid in batches of 20 to 30 on the lower surface of the leaves. And while seeing about the characteristics of larva, so the larva is said to be a minutely irritatable poisonous one, so which used to cause irritation when the spines present in this slug caterpillar touches the human body. So they used to give a slight irritation in the human body, and the young caterpillar which used to be remain gregarious in nature on the lower surface of the leaves, so which used to crave the like a green matter. You can able to see that in the picture. And the adult as well as the final stage of this larva, which used to be yellowish green body bearing, which used to have greenish blue stripes, so it is also called as blue striped nettle grub. It is the other name of caterpillar, like caterpillar. And the next one is pupa, which used to take place on the tree trunk. It used to be like hot shell like cocoon, which used to be grayish chocolate brown cocoon color. And the pupa body is flat on the ventral side as well as convex dorsal side, is the pupa's nature. And while saying about the adult, moth is short and stout. Wings are said to be greenish in color with the fringed with the brown patches along the margins, is the characteristics of adult. So the next one we are going to see is the some other symptoms where it can be seen on Castor slug caterpillar's nature. So the Castor slug caterpillar, which used to feed on the leaves, when the young remains in cluster, they feed by scraping the green matter only on the underside of the leaves. It doesn't affect the upper portion of the leaves, and also the affected leaf may dry and it can be withered and fallen from the castor plant, is the effective symptom of Castor semilupus slug caterpillar. So the management is, the pest should be kept in check by picking the gregarious caterpillars as well as cocoons which was found on the tree trunk, and which can be destroyed by putting them in the water with a film of kerosene, or else we can able to move for the spraying of chemicals like chloropyrifos at 2 ml per liter of water if pest attack is more in the cattle castor field. So the next one is tussock caterpillar, where the scientific name is Urgia postica, and the family is Erebidae. So while seeing about them, eggs which are said to be laid in clusters on the leaves, which is used to be covered by the hairs of the adult, and the larva which is said to be a gregarious feeder. So you can able to see the picture of larva in them, which used to have a tuft of hairs in the prothoracic region on the from the second abdomen and to the eight, and they also have a hair, brownish hair arising from the eighth abdominal segments, and which used to have a pair of long pencil-like hairs projecting from the prothorax in the front side of the larva. So these are the characteristics of tussock caterpillar. And the next is the pupa, which is to be taken place in silk and cocoon. So you can able to see the cocoon which I have placed in the picture, is the silk which is said to be removed, and only I have given the picture of the cocoon and the adult, which is said to be a small adult with yellowish brown wings, and they used to have a bipectinate antenna present in them, and the female is said to be wingless in nature. And the next one we are going to see is hairy caterpillar. So in Castor there are around said to be three hairy caterpillars. The first one is Hippocrates fraterna. So while seeing about the identification, the larva which is said to be fully grown larva, which used to have a red head and a dark reddish brown body completely covered with white hairs and a single tuft of hairs in the head and as well as the pre-anal segment. So the pupation which used to takes place in the plant, inside the plant, with the yellowish cocoon, and the adult is said to be a medium sized moth, and the yellowish color with a pale transverse line present on them with the identical three black spots on the border of the forewings, is the characteristic nature of a Hippocrates fraternae hairy caterpillar. So it is the picture of Hippocrates fraternae hairy caterpillar. You can able to see the black spot which is present in the margins of the wings. So the major symptom caused by Hippocrates fraternae is defoliation, and where the caterpillar used to feed on the leaves, is the characteristic symptom of Hippocrates fraternae. And the next one we are going to see about the hairy caterpillar, where the scientific name is Somnus quintilens, and it also comes under the family Erebidae in hairy caterpillar. So while seeing about this larva, which is said to be yellowish brown head with a middle red as well as the lateral stripes on the body, is said to be yellowish in color, and they also used to have a tuft of black hairs. You can able to see that in picture, the thoracic region which used to have a tuft of black hairs near the head, and they used to have a true legs as well as the prolex in between the segment where the hair is said to be present. And while seeing about the pupa, which is said to be taken place like the before hairy, the one caterpillar we have already seen, it is also takes place in yellowish silk and cocoon. So the adult is said to be a small yellowish moth which used to have a reddish tinge in the wings, and there is also a two lighter lines and spots on the border with the yellow color. So you can able to see that clearly in the picture. So the major symptom is defoliation, where the caterpillar is the damaging stage in the host plant. So the caterpillar which used to feeds on the leaves. So on the next third caterpillar which was present in castor is Olina mendosa, and the scientific name is Eribidae. So the larva is said to be greenish brown in color with the dark prothoracic, and also they used to have a pre-anal tuft of hairs. So in this Olipa species, the tuft of hairs was present in the anal region. So the tips of prolex and are crimson and colored in the Olina species, and the pupa which is said to be yellowish silk and cocoon, and the adult which is said to be bigger yellowish brown moth with bulged abdomen is the characteristic nature of Olipa mendosa species. So it is the picture of Olipa species hairy caterpillar. And the next one we are going to see is castor butterfly, and also it used to have the name of spiny caterpillar, and the scientific name is Aridoni merioni, and also called as Ergolis merioni, which used to comes under the family Nymphalidae. It used to gain the name of spiny caterpillar because of the hairs which was branched in the green body of the caterpillar. So, and also they used to have a yellow stripes on the dorsal side in the larval form. And while seeing about that egg, where the sculptured eggs which are said to be singly laid on leaves in the group of around 3 to 11, and the pupation is a chrysalis pupa. So which where the chrysalis pupa means, which is a complete pupa in the insect classifications. And while seeing about the adult, where the brown color adult which used to have a black wavy lines on the wings is the characteristic nature of adult. So it was the picture of spiny caterpillar. So the major symptom is defoliation, and the caterpillars which used to lie on the upper surface of the leaves, and it also used to feed the margin and causes defoliation is the major symptom. And the next one we are going to see is woolly bear, where the scientific name is Olipa resini. And while seeing the woolly bear, it used to give the same appearance like hairy caterpillar which have already seen Olipa resini, but it used to have some difference, like the larva which is to be robust in nature with a grayish black color, and there is no tuft of hairs. The whole body is said to be covered with a red hair, thick tuft of hairs. But in Olipa species of hairy caterpillar, it used to have a tuft of hairs in the anal region, but it used to have a tuft of hair arising from the whole body. And the adult which is said to be grayish brown or black color, and also used to have black spots on the wings, and the hind wings are pink or reddish color with a black spot is the characteristic nature of woolly bear. So it is the picture of woolly bear species. And so the management for woolly bear is to control the early stages by spraying neem seed a kernel extract at 5%, or else we must need to move for the chemical sprayings like chloripyrifos at 2.5 ml per liter of water, or monocrotopause or quinolpos at 2 ml per liter of water is the effective management in the field level. And now we are going to see about the whitefly, where the scientific name is Trilodorus resini, as well as T. Trilodorus rara, which is also known as T. rara. And while seeing about the characteristics, they used to have nymph and adult. So for the identification, so the nymph, which is said to be a small wax, white waxy cover nymph, which used to remain in large colonies, as well as seeing adult. So which is said to be a small, very small bug, yellowish in color with the white wings. So it is the picture of the whitefly I have already told you now. And the next one we are going to see is leafhopper, where the scientific name is Emposca flavensis, and the major symptom is yellowing of leaves, which was occurred due to the sap which was sucked up by the leafhopper, so which later turned the yellowed leaves into brown color, and which also reduces the leaf in the host plant. So it is the pictures of next one is we are going to see is thrips, where the scientific name is Retithrips syriacus. So and I have given the lecture notes in description. So comment up the video and join us in the Instagram page. If you like the video, like it and share it with your friends, and subscribe to BSc Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch you in next videos.